some what you're talking about. You talked about you being in the triathlon. Saturday, May the 6th, is the Tom Landry Triathlon at the Baylor Center. And a man by the name of David Landsberg is going to be in that event. It consists of a 400-meter swim, a 30K bike ride, and a 5K run. David Landsberg, are you with us?
Yes, sir.
Well, you know, you're speaking to another triathlete here in Rolando Blackman. Your story is quite amazing because you don't have a kidney or a spleen. You received your kidney transplant in July of 1999. A incredible story of courage. Tell us how you've been able to train through all of these physical adversities.
When it all started, being on dialysis, I just saw a room full of people that felt sorry for themselves being on dialysis.
Mm-hmm.
And I decided not to fall into the mental trap of accepting limitations because of, you know, a condition that I had.
Right.
So I started exercising, which wasn't easy. And the more I exercised, the better I felt, and the more I kept exercising. And then when I realized that I was going to need an organ, I decided to use what I was doing to as personal therapy to try to help other people get an organ too. So I did did something that my doctors didn't really want me to do. I did a triathlon last year.
That's incredible. Well, you're here with Rolando Blackman and Mark Stein of the Dallas Morning News, guys. What are your thoughts for David?
These guys are making me feel guilty. I don't know how to swim. I haven't ridden a bike since I was in high school. I probably can't run very far. But, I mean, what have you thought of watching Sean Elliott? I'm sure that's kind of been an inspiration to you watching his comeback.
Quite a bit, actually, because he had his transplant just after I did. And he, very fortunate for him, did not have a lot of complications from the transplant. I, on the other end of the spectrum, had about every complication you can have, got out of the hospital the last time about 7 weeks ago, started training for this event about 6 weeks ago. And so physically, I see him back looking great, you know, in top physical condition, and I'm not near where I'd like to be right now. So he's actually an inspiration to me just to keep going and know that it can be done.
Roy, you think he's nervous?
I don't think he's nervous. I think, David, I wanted to ask you a question. Does this alter your training in any way? And also on the second part of that, could you please give me some tips and help on the swimming part of this that's coming up on the Olympic trials on the 27th?
Well, you're a much better athlete than I am to begin with, so you're far, far ahead of the game. Training-wise, I mean, it's, you know, training's training, whichever athletic event you're partaking in. You know, you just have to be disciplined and consistent with it. And swimming, the important thing is to remember to breathe. Because if you stop breathing in the water, you're in big trouble.
Thank you very much.